having a twin brother is yeah, the most wonderful thing in the world.
It feels just so natural that I don't think about it as a brother or as a friend. I just, it's like a bit of myself in a way.
I never travel by myself, you know, we always do, we always share.
We try to complete each other. I think what he doesn't have, I have, and what I don't have, he has.
Most important also, we push each other in the positive way to surf, and it helps a lot, I think, to improve your surfing and everything else. He's my best friend, you know? We share everything, except girls and boards.
I'm from Norway and a little bit from Portugal also, because we grew up there. I've been surfing for about 12 years. My brother and I were always crazy about water sports or water in general. And then when we were 12, we got a present from our mom, a surf lesson. And then first day we started, we got so hooked to it and got a board the next day and started surfing. And yeah, from there, it was like the best thing we knew.
After 1 year of surfing, we do a competition, like a local competition. And then my brother got first, I got second, and everybody were kind of looking at us. And after, when we turned 16, we got the first main sponsor, that was O'Neill. And they were like, if you want to get a full sponsorship also, then you can go to Australia for 3-4 months. So it was either, you know, sponsorship, travel, or school. So it was an easy choice.
For sure, there's a huge difference by competing and just free surfing, because you are limited in time, and if the conditions are bad, then it's tougher. You have to maybe sometimes hassle more.
Of course, winning is the best feeling. Sometimes losing, especially when you travel halfway of the world and you go and you get one shot, 30 minutes, do a heat and you lose, you look back, you're like, with this money, I could have been in Indonesia for 2 months, you know? And you ask yourself, why? What am I doing?
When we were younger, then there was always been friends saying like, yeah, he's better than you, and you know, stuff like that, that would feed us in a negative side. But when we started traveling and we really knew that the best thing we had was each other, and yeah, really excited to see each other do good.
Before it used to be our passion and our job too, because we were sponsored, but not anymore. So now it just turned out passion, and yeah, we see it. There's still hope, maybe one day we can get sponsors again, but if not, we have also our own projects and we'll keep surfing until, you know, we can't.
In the past, I remember many people think, how can you think like that, just doing surfing, and I should go more for studies because it's more normal in a way. And I always felt that that we did the best possible choice at the time. That was surfing, because we didn't got really rich in money, but we got really rich in experience, and I wouldn't trade that for nothing. I want to live that dream, keep living it for sure.
Wait for it, and you see the swell coming, and you prepare your boards, you prepare everything, and then when that day comes and you catch a good one, it's, yeah, the best feeling. That's in a way what we live for.